Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Peter with speeddesignworks.com. In this tutorial, you'll be learning how to create a speed effects logo using lines. Make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon so as not to miss any future updates. Let's get right into it. When you open the software for the first time, so this is the interface that comes up. So the first thing you do now is click on this create new button. So when you click on it, it brings out this. So this is to select the size of the artboard you want to use. So since we are creating a logo design, we'll be using 1000 pixel by 1000 pixel. So select it, you can double click it or click it and click this create. So it creates the artboard that we are using to create. So the first thing we will do now is click this view. We want to check if the snap to pixel is clicked and the smart guide. So these two are the ones we need checked. So if as they are checked like this, then we are good to go. So we are creating a speed kind of logo, like a letter with a speed kind of effect, something like that. So we have to use I want to use F. We can use any letter. You can use any letter you want. You can even use a word. So, but the one I'll be using to show you today is F. So you can create the F. You can create the F without using the text tool. But instead of wasting time, so I'll just choose any F here. So that's what we'll edit to do the speed. So click on it. F. And then you use Alt and Shift to scale up to the size we want, like that. So to scroll in and out, you hold on Alt and scroll in and out your middle mouse button. And if you want to move from left to right, you use your space bar and move to any direction you want, up and down, left to right, like that. So scale it to the point we want. Okay, I think this is good. So align horizontally and vertically, like that. So we can work with this now. The first thing we would is to change it to a shape. So we'll go to Object, Expand, and OK. And then right click and click on Ungroup. So the next thing we'll do now is to try and make the letter look like it's in motion. So the first thing we can actually do now is to rotate it. So because we want to make sure the letter is like it's, the top part is moving towards the front and the bottom part is moving towards the back. So we can try rotation. So you just try and rotate it. But as you can see, rotating it, the top side is not straight, it's not horizontal, and the downside is not horizontal. So what we can do for this is to make use of the shear tool. So to get the shear tool, get the scale tool, hold and click on the shear tool, like that. So to use it now, you just come to one corner. You can do it from the up or the down. So you just click on it and drag to the left, like that. So as you can see now, the top and the bottom is on a perfect straight line. So that's what we want. I think this is okay. The next thing we'll do now is to make the speed effect at the back of the F. So what we'll do first is click on the rectangle tool, click and hold on it. And then this is the smart guide now. It's showing us where it's starting from. So we'll just draw like a rectangle down to the edge of the down part of the F. And that. And change the color to red. So what we are doing with this rectangle is to try and measure, get the perfect length of this back of the F, like this. So I've counted the amount of lines that we have at the back. So it's 11 we are trying to create. So for us to get the perfect speed, the perfect line, we have to transform this into 11 different lines. So to do that, we come to this, make sure you click on the rectangle tool, and then on the rectangle I mean, and then click on transform. So since we are trying to reduce this height, we want to divide it into 11 shapes. equal shapes. So what we do is like we just divide this by 11 like this and click enter. So this has given us the exact line that will make 11 that will fill up this whole place. You see what I'm talking about very soon. So the next thing we'll do is click on our line segment tool and then target the center of it like this. Click and drag like this. Change it to black and then increase. So we are using stroke so that we have more control over the lines, because if we use shape it will be so much harder for us to do. So this is the best way to do it. So we click here, drag it like that. So make the edges rounded, click on the stroke icon and click the rounded cap like that. So let's drag this let's make another copy of this down like this so that we'll see it as we are moving it, as we are duplicating it down. So hold alt and shift to duplicate. Try and target the middle like that. So instead of to continue doing all those like that, we just keep on doing Ctrl D around so we get all the shapes that we need like that. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's all we want. So we shift them to the left and then can take out this now. So just shift them to the edge like this. You see what I'm doing now. So what we do now, all these middle ones now, you change it to white. All these middle ones. So white. Like that. See that it's looking nice already. Looking like the speed that we need. So now the control that we have not had if we use the shape is that now we can easily make it into any length that we need. So you can just maybe reduce this a bit, reduce this a bit, so we have more control over it now. Move this a bit. You can get this white if it's too close to the end like that. Put this a bit to the back. Yes, like that. Can move this to the front. Like that. So these are shapes, but it looks like there is nothing there just because of the style we used to do it. So we are literally done now. So what we just do is keep on adjusting this. This is just personal preference, so just how you want it. There's no specific right or wrong way to do this, just anyhow you feel is right. So I just want to do mine like this. change this a bit. So there's if you want to make like a design here, like a point here, so what you just do is, that is another advantage of this, just use Alt and Shift, bring it out, and then you select the direct selection to click here and drag it in, so it forms like a circle like that. So instead of going there and creating a circle again, so it just creates it for you. So you can do it for the rest as well, anyone you want it to be in. But yeah, we are done already, just putting the finishing touches to it. Okay, can also put one here. Alt and Shift. Direct selection to click and drag like that. Okay. Can take this in a bit. It depends on you. Okay. So now we can, since all these are curves, like circular shape, so we can make here, because since it's a logo we are trying to create, so it's not good if all these shapes are perfect squares like this. So you can just click here, direct selection tool, and click on the side you want, and then pull this up. Same here, pull this up so that it will also have that rounded shape. Same here, but before I do that, you see that there's like a space here, so you can remove that by simply just putting your triangle, the rectangle there, select everything, and then use your shape builder tool and drag all through using alt and then dragging all through, so it takes that out like that. Okay, so now we can direct selection to select only this side and pull it in. Okay. So we can change all these to shapes since they are parts. So all you need is click on this object and expand. That's when you are done with all the editing, and then you click OK. That. So then you can use your shape builder tool by selecting everything. Select shape builder tool, and then you can take out this, because we don't need it there before. Just using it to draw to get the exact, so that all the spacing between will be exact. Alt is Alt I'm using now. Okay. So you select the black color so that you can join all this together into one shape. You can take this out to also by clicking out. Okay, we have our speed logo. Group it, align horizontally and vertically, and that's all. If you have any question, feel free to leave it in the comment section below. And if you don't want to miss more content like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button and click on the notification bell as well. Thank you.